Hi there. So this is kind of a debut. I wanted to do some testing of equipment and so forth, and so I'm live, and it's very early in the morning. In fact, I very much doubt that I'll have anybody join me at this point. But if you do, great. I just want to let you know that the purpose of the cedar chest is to provide some what I call devos or devotionals to help become more acquainted with God's inspired word. And so while this is just a test this morning to test my equipment and so forth, I'm still going to pray with you and share some scripture. So would you join me and bow your heads? Heavenly Father, Lord, we just come to you this morning. I pray that as we gather in your name, that the word that we share and the thoughts that you bring to my mind, Lord, that it would bless those that hear and that you would be glorified. And we ask all this in your son's precious name. Amen. So the scripture that has meant a lot to me recently was a scripture that actually has to do with the theme of our women's ministry at my church. And our annual ladies retreat was cut very short this year because of the quarantine. When it hit, we were just days from going to retreat. And so I've been studying a lot on this particular scripture and just wanted to maybe share one verse from the three verses. And it's from Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 to 30. And this morning, it is morning, even though it feels like evening, I'm going to share verse 28 with you. Before I read that though, you know, a lot of us view the current circumstances as a glimpse or even the beginning of end times. I kind of look at it as a potential restart or reset, looking back to the basics. Kind of a fresh perspective on our life and our walk with God, actually, to what is really important to each of us. I'm going to take a little detour and share my last 24 hours with you because it was interesting. As I tried to prepare for this, I just kept having technical difficulties and then interruptions, and I'm not complaining about the interruptions. They were welcome interruptions because they're my loved ones. Don't always react appropriately, but again, it's just, you know, the way God uses things to move us through. And so I had this one software I've been using for another broadcast I was doing for the school year, and during the time of the school closures, and it was working fine. And then, you know, we had this vision. I'll tell you right now, and he's gonna hate that I do this, but my husband is the best, and he is my director and my producer, and so we've been talking a lot about how we wanted to roll this out, and he had some ideas, and so we were thinking we wanted to simulcast. We wanted to be able to send it out to a couple different venues so that not only are you seeing this on Facebook Live right now, but it should be streaming to YouTube, and I'll check that after I'm done with the broadcast today. That's the whole point of this, is to see if it actually went to two different directions. And depending on how this goes, you know, we might go to a few more platforms. But so back to yesterday and how it was just incredibly frustrating, and I got to the point where I really was like done, like, okay, this just isn't meant to be. And after all the praying that we did, Yes, I had my doubts. I will admit that. But then I looked up on a sign on my wall that a very dear friend of mine gave me at one time, and it says, "The magic of elves. You say you have a goal. Let me look into your eyes, and now tell me what you're going to do today." And my Joe and I have no doubt that God is directing us in a direction that we're treading lightly and trying to make sure that we stay in his will and his and so I just felt like, is this not what you really wanted us to do? Anyway, so let me tell you about the magic of elves. Elves are exponential little bits, tiny but relentless changes that compound to make a miracle. The power of an elb does not lie in its size, but in its daily occurrence. For an elb to work its exponential magic, the little bit must happen every day, every day, every day, every day. Funny thing, when daily progress meets with progress, it doesn't add, it multiplies. To harness the magic of exponential little bits, you must learn to ask yourself, what difference have I made today? And never go to sleep until you have done a little bit to move yourself closer to your goal. But you must do a little bit every day, no matter how tiny the thing might be. Exponential little bits work both ways. They can lift you up or hold you down. There is much power in the elves. Start with a dollar. And the author of this, Roy H. Williams, he's a marketing consultant, so that's why he's talking money now. So start with a dollar. Double it every day for just 20 days, and you'll have $2,097,150. But if you diminish each day's goal or total by just 10%, a little bit, before the next day's doubling, you'll amass only $793,564. Diminish each day's doubling by 35%, and you'll only have $56,784. A holdback of 95.83%. And so now understand, my miracle worker is Jesus. This is just an illustration. And while this author is far from a donkey, and although a different situation, the Lord did once open the mouth of one to speak. And so I just wanted to point out that the importance of that persistence. Okay. And so that's what brings me here right now to you. Okay. So that was a little detour, but let's read Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. That's out of the New King James Version. So a person who labors is struggling, and a person who is heavy laden is overloaded. There's some irony in my studying lately. I did a study, this is the workbook, called Breathe, and it's by Priscilla Shire. And this was one of the studies that I did with the ladies in preparation for retreat, and just it just was so fitting for the time at that time. And now the irony of starting it shortly before this virus that literally steals people's breath. Let me give you some statistics. Number one, you have to breathe to live. 2 minutes without breath, you pass out. 4 minutes without breath, you could have lasting brain damage. 6 minutes without breath, you're considered brain dead. Okay. And the average person breathes 28,880 breaths per day. Why am I mentioning all this? Well, God manifests himself and spiritual lessons to me often through the physical. And then that translates for me spiritually. So what does breathing have to do with it? Well, how often do you have to think about breathing? Your body knows to breathe. Now, the Hebrew word for breath is the same word for spirit. So, knowing that, when we think of being filled with the breath of God, that's the Holy Spirit. It's the Spirit of Truth. So let me challenge you today. Come to me. That is he is calling to you, but it really is a command, isn't it? Come to me. And so I want to challenge you and me. I'm challenging myself too. Anytime I do this, I'm doing it for all of us, not just you. Take a few minutes today, and I'm going to do the same thing. Just to sit quietly and breathe. Look back over what God has done for us in our minutes, in our moments, in our days, in our months, in our years, all that he's done, and filled with the breath of God as we breathe in, we breathe out, and we think of all these things that he's done for us, especially during this time. I mean, he's done so much. He's closed things off to us. He's caused us to wear these masks and gloves and things like that. The circumstances have caused us, but it really, if you look for it, he's brought families closer. And although we joke about, you know, parents homeschooling, can you imagine what that's done between a child and a parent? You know, brought that relationship closer. There's just so much good that God has done through this. So as we look back through all that God has done during this time for us, and just take that moment to breathe, let's have it cause us to trust him. So he's done all these things in these days and these moments, these minutes, these moments, these days, these months, these years. When we look at what he's done for us, it should give us the trust in him, what he's going to do in the next minute, moment, day, month, year. So as we come to him, it says, come to me and I will give you rest. And so I hope you can find rest in that today. Thank you for joining me this morning. I saw someone come on and go off, but it looks like everything's working well. And so just to kind of close, before I pray with you again, I just want to mention that I'm going to try to do some kind of a weekly devotional with you based on some scripture. And if you have any questions, if you have any topics that you want to discuss with me, I'd love to hear it. I'd love to hear it. Please react and comment, because I'd love to see what you think, your feedback, and mostly if there's anything I can pray for you about, okay? Lord, I just want to thank you for these few moments that I've had. Thank you for a test that was successful. I pray that YouTube went well also, and that that you are glorified and people's hearts are changed and reached through this ministry, Lord. And we just give you all thanks and praise and glory in your son's name. May you grow in the knowledge and grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. And until next time, take care.